damn Nuka Cola song stuck in my head again.
Watch yourself, boss, because we sure will be.
Giving him a second chance. Gage screws this up, he knows we'll skin him alive. So shut up and be patient.
What about you, big guy? Nothing to say on the matter?
As long as he doesn't get in my way, don't much care.
Yeah, figured as much.
Both of you just get out of here. And make sure the others get the message.
The new OB, huh?
Look like much
I reckon
to
you're here to talk to Nisha. She's in charge.
Talk to Nisha.
Hey!
So... you're Gage's little pet project.
Pet project? What's that supposed to mean?
Gage didn't say anything. Apparently, we're not good enough to run this place ourselves. Gage wanted to bring in his own little puppy to replace Coulter. But I guess training a puppy is way easier than getting us to do what he wants.
Last I checked, I'm the overboss.
You survived the gauntlet. You killed Coulter. With Gage's help, of course. So sure, you're the overboss, but that title hasn't meant anything for a long time now. If Gage thinks that'll change overnight, he's dead wrong. Everyone knows we all wanted Coulter dead. Of course, if I had my way, it would have been a slow, painful process. But whatever. Let's get this meet and greet over with. I'm Nisha. I lead the disciples. We've only got one rule around here, and that's keeping the peace of this... alliance. Otherwise, the way we see it, this world stopped caring about rules the moment people started dropping bombs on one another.
What do you mean by keeping the peace?
It means do what you want, but don't get caught. The last thing I need is the operators and Pat breathing down my neck. We can take either of them one-on-one, but I don't like my odds when it comes to double duty. So keep the peace. It's the only rule we need.
This world needs rules. Otherwise, we'll never recover.
Rules are dangerous because people start to trust them. They make you think you're safe, but once you turn your back, you're dead. Coulter thought some sort of rule or code made him untouchable. But he found out he was wrong. The hard way. Although I could give him a little credit. He built the gauntlet, after all. Of course, it was total shit at first. No imagination. But we spiced it up a bit.
How many lives has this gauntlet claimed?
Who's counting? It's at least enough to keep the traders busy. We like to send them in to clean out the bodies whenever things get ripe in there. They don't always make it out alive, of course. The gauntlet never sleeps.
That thing should be shut down. It's dangerous.
Dangerous? People are dangerous. That thing's child's play. Just a bunch of traps and critters. Let's just hope Gage is right about you. He made a lot of promises to get us here. Never followed through. So you better not screw this up, because I'm not about to tolerate another round of bullshit.
I'm the best there is.
Willing to bet your life on that? You see, the disciples don't make empty threats. We make good on them. We aren't swayed by caps like those spoiled brats obsessed with their hair. Or those savage animals who can't behave in public. Fuck this up, and I will kill you. Although, I admit I have even better plans for Gage. But, if you support us and keep your promises like a good little overboss, we back you. You get to live, and everybody wins.
Work for me? I'll get you whatever you want.
Good. You're either smart, or you value your life. Either way, that's exactly what I wanted to hear. Now, if you're really looking to get on my good side, there's no shortage of work around here. So, if you're looking to prove you've got what it takes, you know where to find me.
Hey, asshole. You're listening to Reader Radio. If you come across any herbologist crazies, just ignore them. Told those freaks to stick to their camp.
Nisha
really only has one rule around here. Don't get caught. Heard you put a pretty good beat down on Val. What happened?
I was out of smoke, so she didn't want to hook me up.
That last one died too fast.
We can head on in, Open Boss. Sorry, Max. All anyone's turned up so far is that he's got that pit boy on his arm.
So, our new overboss is a vault dweller.
Or ice the vault dweller.
You can go.
Hey.
Well, I suppose we all owe you for putting down Coulter.
Man was an idiot. Made us all look bad.
A clown stuck in his own little car. I guess we can take some solace in the fact that someone finally gave him what he deserved. I want to know, what did you feel as you did it? When you brought that walking pile of human garbage to his knees?
Taking down an opponent like that? It's thrilling.
Sure looked it.
Perhaps you're better suited to this than I expected. Regardless, Gage's decree means that you're the new overboss. I suppose we can only hope you work out better than the last one. I'm Max. This is my brother, William.
Pleasure.
Along with our co-conspirator, Lizzie, we run this crew. Call ourselves the Operators. You'll come to understand soon enough that we are the only gang you should be backing around here. Because we're the only ones who see this place for what it is. A temple. A testament to the only thing that matters in this world.
And what's that?
Caps. This place was built for the sole purpose of taking caps out of the pockets of fools. We only joined Gage and Coulter's little menagerie in order to restore it to that goal. Though by somewhat more cutthroat methods than I expect its founders intended.
Instead, Coulter had us sitting on our asses for the better part of a year while he lived large in his damn mountaintop.
And that means, if you're going to be in charge around here, we'd like some assurances that you intend to bring this place back to its true purpose. And that we're going to get back to robbing folks of their fucking money.
My goal is to use this place to make all the money I can.
Well, it's about damn time.
I look forward to seeing your claims put into action. So, you're welcome in the parlor whenever you like. Make yourself at home. And if you think you might be interested in running some jobs for us, you just come speak to me. And we'll all be anxiously awaiting getting this place back to doing what it does best.
Max and William normally have me frisk visitors. You get special.
Caught one of the traitors stealing food. Welcome to the nest, boss. We was wondering when you'd make it down here.
Thank you. got a case.
What you want to catch?
The pack lets
no.
it all
hang. I walked right up to it.
Exactly. Most can handle their own shit without bothering me about it. You need help finding your place here?
No. No, I can handle it.
There's plenty of collars in the kennels if you can.
It ain't easy keeping the zoo. We all do our part.
Now that I get a closer look at you, not sure I'm buying this new overboss thing.
You gonna be a problem I need to solve?
Slow down there, boss man. We're just getting to know each other. Name's Mason, the Pack's Alpha. This here's our side of town. You might be overboss for now, but I'm the boss of the Pack, and it's gonna stay that way. Long as you don't go forgetting that, we're gonna be fine.
Your people aren't gonna cause me any problems, are they?
The Pack does what I tell them. You don't get in my way, they won't get in yours.
Let's work together, Mason. See, I'm not interested in ruining your gig.
If that ain't a lie, then things might end up all right between us. Look, it ain't like anyone's broke up about Coulter. Just figured on his replacement being, well, different. Gage says you're the boss now, so you're the boss.
You don't want to be overboss?
Me? Overboss? Nah. Seems to be a short-lived position.
I have big plans for this place. You'll see.
Maybe you're the real deal. We thought Coulter was the real deal, too. He's laying in a pool of his own blood. Don't get me wrong, Coulter was definitely overboss. Not a man to mess with. And things were good in the beginning. Real good. But that was a year ago. Then Coulter went soft. Wanted to take stock in what we achieved.
Things could be worse. Trust me. I've seen it.
No shit. You've all seen it worse. Sure, this place beats living in the shitholes we had out there. But it ain't the palace of cats we signed up for. Ain't none of us happy. Not even the disciples. And they're normally a chipper bunch so long as they're drenched in blood. Things were going to hell fast, but Gage put the brakes on that. Got us together and promised he'd find someone to deal with Coulter.
So what's the real story behind Gage and Coulter?
Hey, I only know what I've heard. Story is that Gage talked Coulter into becoming overboss. And he got you in here, didn't he? Maybe he likes people owing him. Maybe it lets him get things done without getting dirt on his hands. After Coulter went soft, Gage got us behind closed doors and promised he'd get someone to off Coulter. And you did just that. Might have been the whole point of the gauntlet all along.
You can trust me. I'll be a good leader.
No offense, but you just got here. We'll see what you can do. Look, let's cut to the chase. You gonna do right by the Pack? I hear you've been talking to the other gangs.
Be a good dog and do what you're told, or you'll be put down.
Trust me, it definitely won't come to that. One last thing before I let you go. There's always work to do around here, keeping the zoo in order. If you're ever able to lend a hand, drop by. Loyalty's a two-way street.
Mason's been waiting for you. there's machines here that used to spray kids with Nuka Cola. What was wrong with those people?
Mason tarred and feathered the last elves.
Sure, we carry guns, but knives are worth that. It's not fun unless you're hungry.
We'd all considered putting a bullet in Coulter's back at some point. Suppose you just beat us to it.
Boss returns. Well, you're back in one piece. That's a good sign. Everything all peachy with our friendly neighborhood psychopaths? Sure hope you didn't promise them too much. I mean, going a little over the top is part of the game, but you don't want them holding it against you if you can't deliver.
So, what comes next, Gage?
Next? The fun stuff. Time to roll up your sleeves, boss. There's work to be done. This place is huge. Divided up into sections. Parks, whatever the hell they called them back in the day. We need to take them all back. One at a time. Every section we secure gives us a little more breathing room and more resources. You stake a claim, plant a little flag for one of the gangs, and that settles it. It's theirs for good. Who gets what, that'll be your call. Whoever you hand it off to will appreciate it, but the others might get a little jealous. You know how it goes.
Plant a flag? Are you serious?
Dead serious. Look, you leave it up to anyone else, the gangs will all just fight over who deserves the space. A lot of these idiots can't read, so it needs to be as plain as day for them to get on board. They know what to watch for. So that's it. Nice and simple, right? Take a minute. Settle in if you want. And then let's get to it. And hey, we're in this together. So I might as well go all in. You want me watching your back? You just say the word.
No thanks. I got this.
Suit yourself. Change your mind. I'll be around.